Even Huey's father was a retired colonel, had left him a small pension, very small, it's around 200 pounds per month. How was the beggar looking like? The beggar is an old man. In fact, he was not a true beggar, he was a millionaire. That is the climax of the story. Huey is shocked and embarrassed to learn that he has given a sovereign to a millionaire. Helping a millionaire with a little money is something like surprising. Hello everyone, myself Bishobarani, faculty in English from Vidyashram First Grade College, the Temple of Excellence. In today's session for first sem BCom, I am going to discuss about Unit 2, Story 1 called The Model Millionaire by Oscar Wilde. This is a very interesting story written by a famous author by name Oscar Wilde. What am I going to discuss in this particular story? Before I move on to the plot of the story, let us have a brief insight about the author who has written a wonderful story called The Model Millionaire. So what am I going to cover in this session where I'm going to discuss about the story called The Model Millionaire by Oscar Wilde, introduction of the author, that is about Oscar Wilde. Then the plot of the story, that is the main theme of the story or the summary of the story I am going to discuss. Let me move on to the introduction of the author. Hope you all can see in this picture, he is none other than Oscar Wilde, who is the author of this short story called The Model Millionaire. Let us move on to have a brief insight of this famous author by name Oscar Wilde. Oscar Wilde from 1854 to 1900 was an Irish poet and a playwright. One who writes plays is called as a playwright of the Victorian era, best remembered for his aphorisms. That is a phrase of word that expresses in a clever manner is called aphorisms, and epigrams is nothing but the short poems. So Oscar Wilde was an Irish poet and playwright of the Victorian era, best remembered for his aphorisms and epigrams. His works include 9 plays, 1 novel, poems, short stories and essays. Imagine his contribution to English literature, where he has written 9 plays, 1 novel, poems, short story like The Model Millionaire and essays. He was an advocate of the movement Art for Art's Sake, which emphasized aesthetic values more than moral or social themes. Then his works are marked by sharp wit. His works also include wit, that is humor, then satire, that is piece of writing, and flamboyance, that is conflicts. So his works are marked by sharp wit, that is humor, satire, a piece of writing, as well flamboyance called, that is conflict. So Oscar Wilde was an Irish poet and playwright of the Victorian era, best remembered for his aphorisms and epigrams. His works include 9 plays, 1 novel, poems, short stories and essays. He was an advocate of the movement Art for Art's Sake, which emphasized aesthetic values more than moral or social themes. His works are marked by sharp wit, satire, and flamboyance. In 1888, he published his first work of prose, The Happy Prince and Other Stories. Some of the most popular plays of Wilde, Oscar Wilde, as I said, that he has written 9 plays. Some of the most popular plays of Wilde are The Importance of Being Earnest, The Women of No Importance, Lady Windermere's Fan, An Ideal Husband. The Picture of Dorian Gray is the only novel written by him. As I said, he has written 9 plays and 1 novel. So the novel what he has written, the only novel, is called The Picture of Dorian Gray, which is written by Oscar Wilde. The story. Now, what is the story all about? The famous story written by Oscar Wilde, The Model Millionaire. The story, The Model Millionaire, explores the themes of materialism. So a feeling that money and possessions are most important for life. So kindness, beauty and art. The acts of kindness by 2 characters outshine one another. So a person, I'm going to deal in detail in the coming slide, like what is so important about this story, The Model Millionaire. And this story is all about generosity, kindness. And here, the protagonist of the story is Huey Erskine, or you can call the hero or the main character of the story, Huey Erskine, is a struggling youth who is in love with a woman by name Laura. Then later on, what happens is all about the story. Let me move on to the next slide, that is, his proposal to marry her is spurned by her father due to his underprivileged background. So his proposal, as I said, Huey Erskine, who is the protagonist of the story, is in love with Laura, but father of Laura, called Laura, Colonel Merton, doesn't like Laura to marry Huey Erskine because his proposal to marry her is spurned, means not so interested or spoiled by a father due to his underprivileged background. That is, Huey Erskine is not so financially stable because of his very bad financial status. Colonel Merton does not want to get his daughter married to Huey Erskine. Other than that, he likes Huey Erskine for his very good character, charming face, everything. He has almost all the good qualities except for having a very poor financial status, for which Colonel Merton does not want to get his daughter married to Huey Erskine until and unless he is financially stable. His generosity towards a beggar lands him in an unexpected fortune. So what is the author trying to tell in this story? In this story, the author talks about the main character of the story, that is Huey Erskine, who is in love with Laura, the daughter of Colonel Merton, and how Colonel Merton does not want to get his daughter married to Huey Erskine because of his poor financial status, and how this Huey Erskine, as I said, the whole theme of this model millionaire is based on generosity. So his generosity towards a beggar, that is, Huey Erskine's generosity towards a beggar lands him in an unexpected fortune. Though he had a very bad or a poor financial status, how was he able to make it up at the end of the story is very important point to be noted. The strength of his character makes him go through a change of luck and resolves his deadlock situation. Deadlocks, like, for example, is almost like, you know, a situation where you are not able to come to an agreement is called deadlock situation. So here, you know, the generosity of this main character of the story, Huey Erskine, makes him get back his luck, which he had lost long ago. And it is possible for him to get back his fortune is what is all about in the story. At the end of the story, you will get to know. So the strength of his character makes him go through a change of luck and resolves his deadlock situation. There was a situation where he was very much eager to marry Laura, but he was not able to marry her because he could not make up his financial status better, because whatever businesses he did, it was a failure for him. So he was not able to improve his financial status and fulfill the condition of Colonel Merton, Colonel Merton had made a condition that if at all Huey Erskine wants to marry Laura, he has to earn around 10,000 pounds. That was the condition made by Colonel Merton so that Huey Erskine can get married to his daughter called Laura, so that his financial status will improve and he'll look after his daughter very well. That was the condition made by Colonel Merton. The story highlights the irony of social standards and that prioritize individual success and financial stability over human values. So you will get to know that your good deeds are always rewarded at the end. That is the very important thing which we as human beings have to understand. If we help somebody, one day or the other, we will be rewarded for it. But we need to do the help without any expectations. That is what is the very important moral of the story, the model millionaire. Moving on to the plot of the story. Here you can see in this beautiful picture, the characters. So here the main characters of the story, which highlights the story, the model millionaire, is the Colonel Merton. Already I told you all, Colonel Merton is father of, here you can see Laura Merton, the daughter of Colonel Merton. And as I said, the very important hero of the story or the protagonist of the story, the very main character of the story is Hughie Erskine. By seeing his face itself, you can understand he was a charming person, very good looking person, very kind. He was very generous. So he almost had all very good qualities except for a poor financial status, because he did not get much money from his father, and only he was living on the pension that was given by his father. So his financial status was very poor. And Alan Trevor is again a very important person in the story, who is a friend of Hughie Erskine. Here you can see Baron Hosbur, very, very important. The very important character of the story is Baron Hosbur. Anyhow, I'm going to discuss that in the coming slide, why Baron Hosbur is so very important. I think we can highlight these two characters very much. One is Hughie Erskine and the other one is Baron Hosbur. And for Hughie Erskine to meet Baron Hosbur, it was Alan Trevor, who was an artist and a friend of Hughie Erskine. So you can see the five very important characters of the story called The Model Millionaire. One is the Colonel Merton and Laura Merton. Laura Merton is the daughter of Colonel Merton. Then you can see the hero of the story or the protagonist of the story, that is Hughie Erskine. Then Alan Trevor, who was an artist and a close friend of Hughie Erskine. And the Baron Hosbur, who is none other than the millionaire. So all these are the very important characters of the story. And let me move on to the very important plot of the story. Here, Oscar Wilde short story called The Model Millionaire begins by introducing the protagonist Hughie Erskine. So the main character is Hughie Erskine. In this story, how does the author Oscar Wilde describes Hughie Erskine, who is the protagonist of the story? A charming, a good looking young man who is unfortunately poor. He is very good looking, very young, very nice person, very generous person, very kind person, but unfortunately poor. As I said, he was financially very poor. In spite of doing a good number of businesses, he was not successful in his business and he could not make up in his business, and all his businesses were a failure. So that was the reason why he has been described as unfortunately poor. So Erskine, who is the protagonist of the story, he was a charming and a good looking young man who is unfortunately poor. Hughie has many admirable qualities. See, the only drawback which the hero of the story, that is the protagonist of the story, Hughie had, was unfortunately poor. Other than that, he has many admirable qualities. He is kind, generous, well-liked by his friends. Everybody likes Hughie because he is very generous, very kind, and he was also good-looking. However, he lacks one crucial thing, that is money. Main thing which Hughie did not have was what? Money. He had all other qualities except for money. Money is also very important for his livelihood. And not only that, because he was financially poor, that was the reason he was not able to marry his girlfriend called Laura, where her father called Colonel Merton had made a condition that he has to earn around 10,000 pounds in order to him to get married to Laura. Despite his good looks and charm, Hughie cannot seem to secure a stable source of income. He was getting only the pension from his father, which was given by his aunt. Only that was his source of income and that was his source of livelihood. Other than that, he did not have much money, and that was also a very important reason for him not to get married to Laura. His father, a retired colonel, had left him a small pension. So even Hughie's father was a retired colonel, had left him a small pension, very small, it's around 200 pounds per month. And that was not at all sufficient for Hughie to carry on his livelihood with that small amount of money which he got through as pension. So his father, a retired colonel, had left him a small pension, but it was barely enough to cover his modest expenses. Modest means minimum expenses. So it was very, very less amount what he was getting from his father's pension, around 200 pounds, which was not at all sufficient for him to carry on his daily expenses. Then moving on to the next plot of the story. Hughie is in love with a beautiful young woman. So Hughie Erskine, who was very charming, good looking, was in love with a beautiful young woman named Laura Merton. Already I told you, the daughter of a retired colonel called Colonel Merton. So Hughie was in love with a girl by name Laura Merton, who was the daughter of Colonel Merton. Laura loves Hughie in return. So both were loving each other too much, but her father, Colonel Merton, has made it clear that he will not consent to their marriage until Hughie has 10,000 pounds of his own. Though Laura was loving Hughie and wanted to get married to Hughie, but her father did not like. Though Colonel Merton, the father of Laura, liked Hughie Erskine because of his charm looks and because of his kindness, generosity, all the good qualities he admired in Hughie. But the only thing which he did not like was his financial status. So in order to make his daughter live happily hereafter with Hughie, so he made a condition. Yes, of course, I will give you consent. I will agree to get you married to Laura with only one condition. What was that? That he has to earn around how much? 10,000 pounds of his own. So that was the condition. If at all Hughie Erskine earns 10,000 pounds, then easily he can get married to Laura. That was the condition made by Colonel Merton. This condition weighs heavily. This was too much for him. He did not know how to earn 10,000 pounds all of a sudden to get married to Laura. That was a very big amount for him, heavy amount on Hughie, who in desperate, but he was very desperate to marry Laura, but he could not, because he was thinking how to earn this 10,000 pounds all of a sudden to get married to Laura, but has no means acquiring. So he did not get any ways, or he tried businesses, etc., etc., but he was not able to pick up his financial status a better way, because he was a failure in almost all the businesses what he did. So it was like he has no means of acquiring such a huge sum of money. So he was like desperate. Yes, of course, it's very difficult for me to get married to Laura because I'm not able to earn 10,000 pounds, which was the condition made by Colonel Merton. Then one day, while wandering aimlessly through the streets of London, Hughie decides to visit his friend Alan Trevor. This is the dramatic time or a scene where all of a sudden, like, you know, he was just walking through the streets of London. Who? Hughie. He decides. So he was just thinking of how to make money and all. He was just walking around and he thought of visiting his friend Alan Trevor. I already told you all, he had a close friend by name Alan Trevor, who was an artist, right? A talented artist. So he was a talent. So he thought, okay, fine, let me visit my friend by name Alan Trevor, who was an artist. He is in the middle of painting a portrait of a beggar man when Hughie arrives at his studio. So Alan Trevor is busy in painting a portrait of a beggar in his studio. So when Hughie visited the studio of Alan Trevor, what did he observe? He observed Trevor was painting a poor beggar man's portrait. So that was the very, very important scene to be noted. And this is very important thing. You can say this is the highlighted point of the story, because this is how Hughie came across with Baron Hosberg, who was the millionaire. At the end of the story, you'll know how important it was, this particular point, which says that when Hughie Erskine visited Alan Trevor's studio, Alan Trevor was busily painting the portrait of a poor beggar man. How was he looking like a beggar man? You know, the beggar is an old man with a wrinkled face. So how did he know that? Hughie Erskine thought that he was a true beggar. So Alan Trevor was drawing the portrait of a true beggar, he thought. How was the beggar looking like? The beggar is an old man. In fact, he was not a true beggar. He was a millionaire. That is the climax of the story. So that is the biggest twist of the story, is he was not the real beggar whom Alan Trevor was painting. So the beggar is an old man. How come Hughie thought that he was a real beggar? Because the beggar was an old man. with a wrinkled face and tattered clothes. All his clothes were tattered, posing patiently as Trevor works on his painting. So he was just waiting patiently for his portrait to be drawn by the Alan Trevor, the famous artist. Hughie feels a pang of sympathy. Means, all of a sudden he felt like, sympathy means like he felt very sad for the person, beggar, who looks so forlorn. Forlorn means lonely and destitute. He looked like he was without a home or without food. Forlorn means lonely. And destitute means without food or without home. So when he saw the beggar, where Alan Trevor was drawing the painting or the portrait of a beggar, the beggar was an old man with a wrinkled face and tattered clothes, posing patiently as Trevor works on his painting. Hughie feels a pang of sympathy for the beggar who looks so forlorn, lonely and destitute, that is without home or without food. And he was holding his hat like this, so much so it looked like that, it looked as though he was asking for money. He had a very old hat and he was just stretching it out like this, like as though he's asking for money for somebody. But that was the portrait, that was the drawing or the portrait what Alan Trevor was doing, was painting of the beggar. Actually, it was not the fact. The beggar wanted himself to have a photo or a portrait of his being drawn like a beggar. That is the very important point to be noted in the story. During a break in the painting session. So there was a small break in the painting session. So Trevor steps out of the room for a moment. So when Alan Trevor was in the studio busy drawing the portrait of the beggar, for some time Trevor took a break. So he wanted to have a small break, I think. So he just went out of the studio. And leaving Hughie alone with the beggar, who were alone left in the studio. As I said, Hughie visited the studio at that point of time where Alan Trevor was drawing the portrait of the beggar. And Alan Trevor went out for a break, for a small break. And at that point of time, who were left alone in the studio? It was only Hughie and the beggar. Hughie moved by compassion. So when he saw the beggar, Hughie, as I said, what the very important concept of this story itself is what? Hughie was very generous man. So when he saw the beggar, he felt so very compassionate towards him because he was looking so tired, with tattered clothes, with wrinkled face, with the torn clothes, all that. He felt very sad for the beggar and moved by compassion, reaches into his pocket and finds a sovereign. So as soon as Trevor left the studio, Hughie went near the beggar and he felt very sad for the beggar and he thought, oh, let me help this beggar. So what he thought, he just put his hand in his pocket and he had the only money that was left out was a sovereign. And that was the only means of his expenses he had to bear the whole month with that sovereign money. That is the money what he had, the left money is nothing but the sovereign what he had in the pocket. So what did he do? Hughie, moved by compassion, reaches into his pocket and finds a sovereign. So he wanted to help the beggar. He knew Alan had gone out of the studio. So he saw the beggar. He felt pity for him. As I said, he was so very generous. And when he looked at the beggar, he felt very sorry for him, for his state as a beggar. And so he wanted to help him. So what did he do? He just put his hand in his pocket. And what was there in his pocket? The little money. What was that money? A sovereign. The last bit of money he has. So it was the last bit of money what Hughie had to bear his expenses for the remaining month. So it was very meager amount what he had. It was very much needed for him to carry on his daily expenses till the month end. Because month end he used to get the pension. It's around £200. Right? So without thinking twice, imagine how generous and how kind this Hughie Ershine is. That is what I said. If you are kind and if you are compassionate and if you do good deeds to others, definitely you will be rewarded. That is the very important point to be noted here. Hughie was very kind, very generous, very compassionate, felt sad for somebody who was really very in a very bad condition. So without thinking twice, without even thinking about his expenses, what did he do? He gives it to the beggar, who thanks him profusely. So without having a second thought, first of all, when you have little money, you think, oh, fine, let me fulfill myself. Then later on, I'll give somebody. So with the little money what he had, he wanted to help others. So imagine how helping person this Hughie Ershine was. So even without thinking a thought twice the bit of money what he had in his pocket, that is a sovereign, and gives it to the beggar. And the beggar thanks him profusely. So the beggar is so very happy to receive the money, thinking that though he had a very little money, he is helping me. So actually, in fact, he is not a true beggar, he was a millionaire. He feels a sense of satisfaction in helping someone in need. Yes, of course, when you do kind deeds or when you help somebody, you will have that satisfaction. Yes, of course, today I have done a very good deed. I am able to help somebody who is in need of. So you will have that self-satisfaction. That is what even Huey had when he gave back the little money, what he had in his pocket to the beggar who was in the studio. Even though it means he is now penniless. See here, very important. With all the whatever remaining money he had, he has given it to the beggar. Though he knew he is penniless, but he is still very happy. See, that is what is called generous nature, kind nature. When you help somebody, even though you are not well off, financially very good, but yet you try to help others, that is very, very important character of a person. And that is a good character of a person which he had. Moving on to the next point of the story, when Trevor returns. So after that, as I said, Trevor had left the studio to take a small break. And who was left alone in the studio? It was only the Huey and the beggar. So after that, again, Trevor returns back to the studio. He and Huey chat for a while. So after that, they sit for a while. The beggar goes away. After Huey gives him the sovereign, he thanks him and he leaves. So Trevor explains that the beggar is a professional model named Baron Hosberg. So once Trevor comes back to the studio, Trevor and Huey sit for a while and chat. So during their chatting or during their communication with each other, Trevor explains that, did you think he was the true beggar whose portrait I was drawing? No, he was not the true beggar. He is a model. What do you mean by model? There are people who just pose for a particular photo. So he was a very rich person, but he wanted a portrait of his as a beggar. So that is very important point to be noted in the story. That is, the beggar who was getting his portrait drawn as a beggar was not a true beggar, but he was none other than a model named Horan, that is Baron Hosberg, one of the richest men in Europe. Imagine, he was not a true beggar, which Huey did not know that. Unknowingly, thinking that he's a true beggar, he had helped him. But when Trevor tells him that the beggar was not a true beggar, he's a model and he's the richest person in Europe by name Baron Hosberg. And when this point was told to Huey was so very surprised. Of course, when you think something and something is happening, something is told, you definitely will feel surprised. So that was a surprise what Huey got from his friend when he got to know that the beggar was not a true beggar but a very, very richest person in Europe, and he was a model millionaire. Then Huey is shocked and embarrassed. Why is he embarrassed? He's thinking that, first of all, when he got to know that he's a millionaire or a very richest person, he get embarrassed. Why? Surprised, yes, of course. He gets shocked because he thought him to be a poor beggar and he helped him. And he gave only the meager money or little money what he had in his pocket, that is a sovereign. But he was not a true beggar. He was shocked for it. At the same time, he was embarrassed. Why he was embarrassed? Model millionaire, he's a millionaire. He has lots of money. And he has given that meager money to a person who is a millionaire. That made him embarrassed, feel very sorry for it, for having given, that he has given a sovereign to a millionaire. See here, this point is very nice. Huey is shocked and embarrassed to learn that he has given a sovereign to a millionaire. Helping a millionaire with a little money is something like surprising. Yes, of course. Right? That was the reason why Huey was surprised, embarrassed also. Trevor finds the situation amusing and promises not to tell even about Huey's charitable act. So at that point of time, he tells all this to his friend. I didn't know that he was a beggar, so I gave him a sovereign. I thought him to be a true beggar. I was feeling very sad for that beggar, and I thought, let me help him out. So the bit of money what I had in my pocket, I've given to the beggar. All this story he would have told. What happened in between the break, when Trevor went out of the studio for a break. So what happened between Huey and the beggar, he told. So then what does Trevor say? Finds that situation amusing. He finds very surprising, amusing. My Lord, first of all, he is a millionaire and you have gone and helped a millionaire with a small bit of money, that is a sovereign. But he tells, promises Huey not to tell anyone about Huey's charitable act. The next morning, Huey receives a surprise visit from a representative of Baron Hosberg. But you know what happened in between this, before this? You know, the beggar had asked all about Huey from Alan Trevor. Then at that point of time, Alan Trevor would have told the beggar, who is a model millionaire, that is, who is not a true beggar, but a model millionaire, that is Baron Hosberg, about the financial condition of Huey. Alan Trevor tells Baron Hosberg that Huey Ershine is a very good person, very generous person. He has all good qualities except he was unfortunately poor. And he also told Baron Hosberg about the condition what Colonel Morton had made to get his daughter married to Huey, that he had to earn how much? 10,000 pounds. Then only Colonel Morton will give permission for his daughter to get married to Huey. That condition was made to be known to the Baron Hosberg, who was a millionaire. So this is a very, very important key point to be noted. Baron Hosberg got to know the poor financial status of Huey from Alan Trevor. So only then Baron Hosberg feels so very happy. Though he's poor, he wanted to help me out, thinking me as a poor beggar. That is very important. What a kind nature Huey has. In spite, he is not having much money. He is very poor. But in spite of it, with little bit of money what he has, he wants to give it to a beggar. That was a very kind nature of Huey, which impressed the Baron Hosberg. So he was very much happy about Huey's character, that such a kind person. So that made Baron Hosberg feel happy for Huey, and he wanted to help Huey Ershine to get married to Laura by giving that 10,000 pounds, which was a condition made by Colonel Morton. So what happens the next? The very important, the climax of the story is what? The next morning, so everything, all this happened. So next morning, Huey just goes back to his house. So in the next morning, what happens? Huey receives a surprise visit from a representative of Baron Hosberg with an envelope. So somebody, who is that somebody? Somebody is none other than the representative of Baron Hosberg. So a representative or a person was sent by Baron Hosberg, and he was called as a representative of Baron Hosberg. He visits Huey's house in the morning with an envelope. You know what was written on the envelope? It was written, a wedding present from a poor beggar. See, so what was written in the envelope? What was written in the envelope that was carried by the representative of Baron Hosberg? It contained a wedding present from a poor beggar. See the kindness of even Baron Hosberg also. Though he was a millionaire, he did not show off that he is so very rich by writing his name. What did he write on the envelope? He wrote, a wedding present from a poor beggar. And you know what happened? The representative delivers a letter from Baron which contains a check. So what was there in the envelope? In the envelope, there was a check. Check for what amount? It was for 10,000 pounds. A check for 10,000 pounds. The money that was needed by Huey to fulfill the condition of Colonel Morton to get married to Laura, who was his girlfriend. So that is a very, very important, climax of the story, the model millionaire, and also very, very nice point to be noted here. Like even the kindness, here you can see the kindness of two very important characters. One is Huey as well the Baron Hosberg. He would have just received the money from Huey and would have kept quiet. But Baron Hosberg didn't do that. He tried to understand the status of the all about Huey from Alan Trevor, and when he got to know the condition of Colonel Morton to get his daughter married to Huey, where he has to fulfill to earn around 10,000 pounds of money. So he knew all that. See how kind of even Baron Hosberg. So when he sent his representative to Huey's house with an envelope carrying a writing saying that a wedding present from a poor beggar. And what was there in the check, in the envelope? There was a check of about 10,000 pounds, the exact amount he needs to marry Laura. Then with a check, he went and gave to Colonel Merton, and he got married to Laura Merton. And even Baron Hosberg also attended the marriage of Hugh Hershine with Laura Merton. So how wonderful this story is all about. And it's a very nice story written by Oscar Wilde. Indeed, I really enjoyed reading the story and understanding the important characters of this very important story called The Model Millionaire by Oscar Wilde. So the very moral of the story is that if you are kind and if you are generous, definitely one day or the other you will be rewarded. But you have to help somebody or do good deeds without any expectations. Then only you will be rewarded one day or the other for your good deeds. That is the very important moral of the story, right? And the Baron writes that he was touched by Hughie's generosity and wants to reward him for his kindness. So what else was written in the envelope other than the check containing a check for £10,000? The Baron writes, what does he write? He was touched by Hughie's generosity. So Baron writes that he was moved by his generosity and wants to reward him for his kindness. As I said, you will be definitely rewarded for your kindness and generosity. Without any expectations, you have to do good work. Hughie is overjoyed and immediately goes to see Laura and her father. Now, you know, Hughie is so very happy. Why? Because he has got what? He has got £10,000, which was very much needed by Hughie to fulfill the condition of Colonel Morton. And he was so happy. Why he was happy? Because he could now get married to his girlfriend whom he loved more, that is Laura Merton. Colonel Merton, upon seeing the check, finally gives his consent to the marriage. Of course, when Colonel Merton sees the check for about £10,000, why will he not agree? Definitely he agreed. He gave his consent to the marriage. What? That is, he tells his daughter, yes, of course, you can marry my daughter called daughter Laura Merton. Hughie and Laura are married, and soon after, and they live happily ever after. Why they lived happily ever after? So with that, you know, he started earning later, and he also had his girlfriend married. So all that made him to live happily ever after. So here at the end of the story, you can see Hughie's act of kindness to a man he believed to be a poor beggar. He believed the person whose portrait was drawn by Alan Trevor, that is a beggar's portrait, he thought that he was a real poor beggar, ultimately changes his life for the better. See, that 1 second of his kind act changed his whole life. You know, one small generous act of Hughie gives the little bit of amount what he had in his pocket, that is a sovereign, to the poor beggar who was not in reality a poor beggar. He was a model millionaire. He was a millionaire. So that changed his life forever. See, Hughie's act of kindness to a man he believed to be a poor beggar ultimately changes his life for the better, proving that generosity and compassion can lead to unexpected rewards. I told you all, no? Like if you help somebody who is in need, even though we don't have much, little money what we have, and if you help somebody who is in need, definitely you will get unexpected rewards. That is the moral of the story. Hope you all have understood this very important story, which is there for your first sem, BCom English, The Model Millionaire by Oscar Wilde. Thank you.